What do you do when a prospect calls up and says, hey, I just want a quote? Do you just send it to them and hope something good's going to happen? And nothing ever does, because rarely does anything good happen if you have no control over it. It might happen, most likely won't. Well, and they say, hey, I just want the pricing. No big deal, just want some pricing. And do you give it to them? If you do, you're stupid. You're not a sales. A web page can do that. And if you're doing just what a web page can do, who needs you? Don't do it. I refuse to. When I was a rep, it wasn't long ago, people always call, hey, just give me the price. And I go, well, on what? On the thing you sell. I go, which one? And what are you trying to do? I turn it back on them. I get engaged with them. I get them talking. And if they refuse, I go, I can't just give you a price. I don't know what you want. Let's talk about it. If you don't want to talk about it, then you can't be that interested, right? You know? If you can't find it on the internet, then you got to call me and we got to get engaged. And if you don't want to talk, you're not going to buy anything. So why am I wasting my time? It's real selling.
Sales, in particular appointment setting. Now, this is possibly the most important thing that you're going to learn in your entire training. The number of appointments that you can successfully set will relate directly to the amount of money that you make. There is no question about that. Everyone should, once you've qualified that, you know, they're after suits and it's highly likely that we'll have a suit that suits them. Once you've qualified them, every single person should have us out to at least see our suits. So I challenge you, think about that. If you could book an appointment with every lead that we send you, with every network lead you get, do you think your income would stand a good chance of going up or not? Well, that's the goal. That's what should happen. There are no firm quotes over the phone. That's a cop-out. I'm sorry, I've got to be strong about this. A web page can do that. If someone wants a price, you give them a range. Look, it'll be between 160 and 250. What I can tell you, the most you'll pay is 250. And it'll probably be less than that, but it depends on how many suits, it depends on exactly the date of the wedding, it depends on exactly the accessories that you decide to choose, it depends on if all the guys can be at the fitting, whole variety of things. But I tell you what, I'm happy to come out. We've also got the best price guarantee, so I can say, I guarantee you'll pay less than the shops. So I'm happy to come out, dress you up, show you a whole bunch of suits, and give you a firm price once we've worked through all of that. So we know that, yes, you've got the look you're after. And look, if you're happy, go ahead. If you're not, no problem. We'll shake hands and you've got some ideas. That's how you handle the give me a quote objection. It follows the same format as we follow everywhere, which is qualify, present, and close. So you should by now have your qualifying questions rehearsed and down pat. They should become part of your speech habits now. Questions like, look, tell me a bit about your wedding. Have you chosen bridesmaids' colours? Do you want to match those colours to the groomsmen's neckwear? How many groomsmen are there? Are all the groomsmen in the same area? You ask that because if they aren't, that's another big advantage to use us. What look are you going for? Look, are you concerned about the photos in 20 years? Do you want a classic traditional or classic stylish look that's going to look great in 15, 20 years? You know, the answer most times is yes. Well, look, this is the one time you probably should look to be in a tuxedo. Have some satin on your lapel. It's the one time in your life you want to look at like Brad Pitt at the Oscars. You can wear a lounge suit anywhere. This is your this is getting married. This is the one time you should be going, not at the Oscars style. Because it'll cost them $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 to get a pure wool tux. So that's the business we're in. We should always push formal. Once you've qualified them, you'll identify them. Yep, we've got a suit for them. They need suits. You should get into their home. There is no question about this. So qualify, present. You explain to them. You explain that they've got to use us. Look, we'll take care of everything. I'll come here. We'll dress you up. We'll look at a bunch of suits. If you're happy, I'll explain how I'll take care of everything. I'll deliver the suits to you 10 days before your event. Now remember, if you go through the shops, you'll probably be getting them 1 or 2 days before. If there's any issues at all, you're running back and forth to the shops. That's stress. That's why we do it 10 days before your event. I'll also collect the suit, organise to have the suits collected after the event, all free of charge. We guarantee it'll cost you less than the shops. So that's presenting. You then close for the appointment. Now, there's one of two ways to do this. You can try and get all the groomsmen there. So look, when's the best time to get the groomsmen together? You never ask, can I book you in for a fitting? Because I guarantee you, you'll bat about 0%. And it's not because they don't need suits or our service isn't awesome. It's because you've asked the wrong question. So you will have heard me say this a bunch of times. It's called the alternate of choice. When's the best time? While I've got you on the phone, when's the best time to get the guys together? After hours during the week or on a weekend? Saturday or Sunday? AM or PM? Does any dates in the next 2 or 3 weeks sort of jump out and work for you better than others? Once you've identified that date, say, well, look, I'll tell you what, I'm going to text that info to you so you can discuss that with your fiancé. That way, when you call back to say, yep, that's fine, it hasn't been booked, because that happens all the time. I'll also send you an email so you've got that there, and I'll give you a buzz in a couple of days just to confirm that. If it needs to change, it's not a problem. So again, then you confirm what you're going to do. I'm going to come out, we'll measure the guys, we'll dress you up. If you find something you like, I'll ask you for a deposit to secure the suits for your wedding day. Now remember, you've got to create urgency. Your wedding day is, and it doesn't matter, anything from spring through summer is in the middle of bridal season. So what I can say is the longer you leave this and the closer to your wedding date that you book, regardless of whether it's us or anyone else, the more you'll pay and the greater the chance of the stock you want not being available. And that's just a fact. So our business is all about margin for error. If you find something that you love, you can leave a deposit. That takes it out of the stock control system. It's done. If not, cost you nothing. Risk reversal. There is nothing to lose. Now, there's a way you can cheat even further, and there's a couple of guys using this strategy to really good effect, and it's called a consultation. The single biggest objection to setting a fitting is, oh, it's too hard to get the guys together, I'll have to call them all, and it's just another hassle that we want to try and avoid. So I say, I tell you what, I just need you and your fiancé. What are you doing this Saturday? Is Saturday, you know, is it AM, PM or Sunday better? What are you doing this weekend? Is Saturday or Sunday? Can you spare 20 minutes for me? Now, it's very easy to get them to set aside 20 minutes for just them to talk about suits instead of an hour and a half to get five guys together. The other advantage to this, one, you will basically be able to fit, and there's guys now that are setting 5, 6, 7, 8 consultations a week. It's easy to do. There's nothing for them to lose. You're just going to pop in, go through exactly the look you're after, show them a bunch of suits, and just get some ideas. If you don't find anything you like, I'll shake your hand and I'll leave. There's nothing to lose. It'll only take 20 minutes. So that's the first step. The second thing is the feedback is these are actually easier to close because there's less distraction. You haven't got the best man who's the suit expert. You haven't got the mother of the bride who wants her opinion in there and she knows suits and she's been a tailor and she's done this. You haven't got any of that. You've just got total focus. It's you and them. You can really get them emotionally involved. You can really start to build rapport because it's just you and them. You can really work on building those magic moments and getting them to the point where they just want to use you because they like you. Because you've added so much value, why else would they want to go anywhere else? So this is a massive tool. It's called a consultation. And everyone that qualifies should have a consultation with us. If they're within an area you can drive to, you can set 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can do 5, 6, 7, 8 of these on a weekend, on a day. So I ask yourself, if you could have 2 fittings a weekend or 8 consultations, do you think your chances of earning more go up or down? It's a no-brainer, isn't it? And especially the next step that we're going to teach you is how to structure your in-home fitting, so that you will measure, present and close, and you will add so much value, you will create so much rapport that you will basically get every single in-home fitting you go to. Isn't that exciting? You've just been given a tool to get massive amounts of consultations or fittings, and we're going to teach you how to get basically every fitting you go to. So right now, I'd like you to think about all the leads sitting in your inbox where you haven't contacted them, or you haven't been able to set an appointment. and think, how many consultations can you fit? And I want you to go out now and practice what you're going to say. And I want you to write down what it is, practice it, role play it with whoever you can role play it with yourself, and then perfect it. Practice it on clients and get good at it. Because this is your craft. This is what you've got to be the expert at. It's so simple. It's speech patterns. If you practice it enough, you'll become the expert at it, and you'll make so much more money.